morning, lovely audience. Yeah, I said lovely audience. So, good morning. Okay. Yeah. So, being an entrepreneur, may it be a male or a female in any part of the country, I feel is always a challenge. As an entrepreneur, you always have an idea, a goal, a purpose in life. Every day, you are running behind that goal and a purpose, and we are trying to make it a reality. You risk everything being an entrepreneur. Being an entrepreneur, you risk your time, you risk your self-reputation, you risk your money, and most important, my dear friends, you risk your heart and soul. Now, looking at the entrepreneur, most of the people just only see the final product as an entrepreneur, a successful one. They look for fame, they look for money, they look for the final end product. But very few in this country can understand and feel what struggle he must have faced in the past to become an entrepreneur. And my journey is all about, the presentation is all about inspiring the youth. Being an entrepreneur, a trainer, a leadership coach, a public speaker, I am inspiring the youth. I am inspiring the youth of this nation. I started my entrepreneurial journey at the age of 23, just out of the college, and when nobody thought I would be an entrepreneur. Again, I can say I became a public speaker when no one thought so. And I am continuing this journey, and the big question is how I became an entrepreneur. The pundit to question is how. Because I always had that big why. And what is that big why? I just want to tell you story as an entrepreneur. If you understand my past, in the 8th standard, I still remember I was studying in St. Lawrence School of Aurangabad, and I was surprisingly second in the class. Second from the bottom. Yes, you heard it right. I was second from the bottom, ranked second last in the class. Looking at the 10th standard, I somehow managed to pass the 10th standard with an average of 60%. I managed to pass 11th standard, and then I took admission in 12th standard in Devgiri College of Aurangabad, Maharashtra. Now in 12th standard, again, tragedy happened with my life, and I failed in 12th standard again. Failing in 12th standard, I repeated my 12th standard and passed the 12th standard, took the admission in an engineering college named JSPM College of Rajarshi Shahu Engineering College, Pune. Now when I did the admission in Pune, everything was going according to the plan, the first year, the second year and third year. But we always say, behind the success, there are a lot of failures. And in the third year, I was detained from my college. I was detained from my college in 2012. I came back with a strong why. I completed the engineering now very seriously and was passed out in 2014. In 2014, I passed out and I took admission for my post-graduation as ME in construction management, and meanwhile I started my business, I started my entrepreneurial journey. Now, talking about the psychology of India, the entrepreneurship, the ease of doing businesses, talking about these things, I feel there is a problem with the psychology of people in India. That's why we are not ranked among the most nations who are top on the ease of doing businesses. I feel there is a psychological problem. You will correlate once I told you. The problem is we think of conventional businesses. We think of conventional thoughts. Here we think of, I can say, fear. We think of fear of failures. We think that we will be failed like that. And this is the psychology we are facing in India. But I am truly fascinated by the nation called Israel. I am truly inspired with the nation called Israel, a startup nation. If you see the Israel map, you can see almost 250 plus companies, MNC companies, have the R&D centers in Israel. Talking about the big companies, IBM started first in 1970s. They started their R&D center in Israel, the first one, outside US. Later on, Intel, Microsoft, talking about Apple, the big company, started their R&D office in Israel in 2011. And today, the nation is called as a startup nation. Today, Israel is having more than 250 MNC companies in Israel. Now, what makes this company attract towards Israel? Try to understand. The only thing is the psychology. If I talk about what special Israelis have, you must be thinking there must be a good manpower. Population is around 90 lakh, equivalent to maybe lesser than Mumbai. They have population in terms of area, again, very less area compared to Thane. It's equivalent to Thane, the nation. So what is the main thing? The main thing, if you see, is only the psychology. The psychology to overcome the failure. If you see these people, they have made a lot of innovation. A lot of innovation they have made. The psychology to see failure. You can see failure in India, we look at as a failure. We look at embarrassment. Failure is equal to embarrassment. Failure is equal to something negative thoughts. But in Israel, if you see the psychology is failure is equal to experience. Failure is equal to learnings. And failure is equal to positive thoughts. And I'm here to change that kind of psychology. My dear friends, entrepreneurship is nothing but problem solving. Whenever there is a problem, there is an opportunity. Just we need to change the way we think. Talking about again Israel, lot of innovations they made. Lot of, I can say, innovation in agriculture, innovation in technology. Why that happened? That happened because they converted conventional method to innovation. They converted that adversity to advantage. And they converted that fear of failure into a positive message. So we need to learn that kind of thing. Again, taking an example of India, you must have heard about Pro Kabaddi. Pro Kabaddi is the best example how entrepreneurs think. If you talk about Kabaddi, Kabaddi was a diminishing sports in India. But what Star Sport did, they converted that conventional Kabaddi into an innovation, an interesting one. They changed some kind of rules in Kabaddi and they made it a Pro Kabaddi. They converted that adversity into advantage. They converted that adversity to advantage and they made, and most important, my dear friends, they took the risk. That is risk-taking ability. They took the risk to launch that Pro Kabaddi, and we all know the success story of Pro Kabaddi in our nation. It has become a success story. It has become a case study to learn. Now, what mantra I want to give from this platform as an entrepreneur is focus on the bottom of pyramid, that is BOP. Now, what is BOP? If you talk about India, 20% or I can say very less percentage, around 10 to 20% people are categorized into the rich people. Middle class, again, 30 to 40%. But more than 50% of the people are in the bottom of line, bottom of the pyramid. And if we focus on the bottom of the pyramid, we can be a good entrepreneur. How? Understand about BOP, that is bottom of the pyramid. In the bottom of the pyramid, these people are poor people, ignored by the industries, ignored by the innovation. These people need electricity. These people having a problem of water crisis. They have a problem of sanitation. And you must be thinking, we should give them the charity. But charity always is not the right answer, my dear friends. Giving a charity will not motivate the entrepreneurs. Instead, we can give them some kind of services, they need services, not charity. We can give them services in a lower prices. We can generate low profit margins, but we can earn more money as an entrepreneur if we focus on BOP, that is bottom of the pyramid. The mantra is very simple. We need to focus on the bottom of pyramid. And that's why I always say, if you want to become a tomorrow's entrepreneur of India, you must have a combination of technical knowledge and psychology. If you have that psychology of overcoming the fear of failure, taking that risk and overcoming to the adversity, converting it to the advantage, you are tomorrow's leaders. And I am building that kind of psychology. I am giving business ethics to the people. I am training people on leadership. I am training the people on communication, personality development. Also, I am developing people into the technical knowledge. Talking about my timeline, how I converted that pass out in 2014 till 2019. Talking about the timeline, as I said, I am focusing on the two things, and that is technical expertise for the youths and the psychology for the youths. Talking in terms of technical expertise, I am having a centers across Maharashtra, having 5 centers in 5 districts, training on building design, structural design, estimation and costing, project planning and management, and we are training on different IT training tools, data science, AI, machine learning, training on industrial automation, PLC, SCADA, training on embedded system, microcontrollers, doing and giving them vocational kind of training to make them technical. And talking about psychology, I'm training them on leadership coaching, training them on entrepreneurship development, training them on different things and trying to make this happen. I started my YouTube channel way back in 2018, sharing the videos in Marathi, Hindi and English. And the purpose of my life is to make the youth the combination of technology and psychology. And here I am the unique combination of technical and motivational person. And that's it from my side. Thank you so much. I am signing off.